When we're doing excavation work, if we have trench shields in place or closed sheet shoring, if you like, then no one should ever really be outside of that. Definitely trench shields. No one should ever be outside of trench shields. The trench shield is there to protect the worker that is working inside the trench shield. Doesn't prevent the trench from collapsing. So once someone is outside of that trench shield, there is a possibility the trench may collapse and may be engulfed. And generally, most of the incidents that we do go to that involve trenching works where trench shields are in place, the incidents happened outside of the trench shields. When we talk about prevention of collapse, we're talking about things like benching and battering. They actually control the risk of the trench collapse, whereas the trench shields protect the worker that's inside the trench shield, don't actually prevent the collapse. Shields are generally used in deep excavation work or deep trenching works so that they can be stacked on top of each other, and then basically with unstable soil, a lot of times we will put the shields in place. So the excavator is the excavation's dug down to a certain depth, the shield's lowered in place with the excavator, then the access is put in and the worker goes inside the trench shield. When we talk about shoring works, depending on how much room we have on site, soil conditions again, generally we will come up a metre from the bottom of the trench and then bench across, so just a basic bench across another metre and then up a metre. So basically it's a metre by a metre by a metre out. When we talk about battering, we generally batter back on the angle of repose, which is a natural fall of the soil, or else what we call the zone of influence, which is generally a 45 degrees. So the depth of the trench, we come back on an angle, and that what that does then is it takes the weight off the top edge of the trench and prevents it from collapsing.